हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू इजी इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स। दिस इज मिस कीर्ति नाशिककर। सो सेमीकंडक्टर डायोड्स वी आर डिस्कसिंग एंड वी हैव सीन ऑल दिस टॉपिक्स रिलेटेड विद द पीएन जंक्शन डायोड, इट्स फॉरवर्ड रिवर्स कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स, वीआई कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स, जीनर डायोड, एलईडी, फोटो डायोड, एंड इन द लास्ट लेक्चर वी हैव सीन अबाउट द ऑप्टोकपलर। टूडे वी विल डिस्कस सोलर सेल वर्किंग प्रिंसिपल एंड कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स। दिस इज द लास्ट टॉपिक ऑफ सेमीकंडक्टर डायोड्स। सो इट इज अ सेमीकंडक्टर डिवाइस विच कन्वर्ट्स लाइट एनर्जी डायरेक्टली इनटू इलेक्ट्रिकल एनर्जी, और वी कैन से द लाइट विच इज कमिंग फ्रॉम द सन इज कन्वर्टेड इनटू द इलेक्ट्रिक सिग्नल और इलेक्ट्रिक करंट बाय यूजिंग द सोलर सेल। एंड दिस property or this conversion of light energy into electricity is known as photovoltaic effect, and solar cell works on the photovoltaic effect because it converts light into electricity, so that's why it is also called as photoelectric cell, because when it is exposed to light it can generate or support any electric current, and for this purpose it does not require any external voltage source. So this is the basic difference between that of the solar cell and photodiode, because photodiode perform the same operation, but it requires the reverse biasing of the external voltage. But in case of solar cell, it performs the photovoltaic effect without supply of any external voltage source. This is the symbol of solar cell, as it is capturing the light, so that's why the arrows are in the inward direction, and this is nothing but the anode and cathode. Anode is the positive terminal and cathode is the negative terminal. So let us see the solar cell working principle. As you can see in the diagram, the light is coming into the solar cell. Actually, this is the panel which consists of number of solar cells. So they just capture the light, and light consisting of photons, so that's why these photons use their energy to the electrons, and that's why they become free electron. They goes to or jumps from the valence band to the conduction band, and that's why the electron becomes free now. And as the electron becomes free, now they are capable of conducting the current. So that's why current moves through the device. So again, let me explain the working principle. When it is exposed to light, it can generate electric current without any supply of external voltage source. This is nothing but the photoelectric effect. So when photons in sunlight strike solar cell surface, they are absorbed by semiconducting material and electrons freeze from their atoms, generating electric current. Solar cells are connected in series in the form of an array of panels with current and voltage specification. It produces DC current. So the technical specifications of solar cell includes type of semiconductor used, efficiency, maximum power output, and geometrical properties. Now the two important quantities to characterize a solar cell are, first one is VOC, which is the open circuit voltage, and next one is ISC, which is the short circuit current. Now open means you must consider the infinite load resistance, because the voltage between the terminals is measured when there is no current. No current means zero current. So from the Ohm's law, I equals to V upon R, and I will be zero only when R is infinity. So that's why infinite load resistance. Okay, so open circuit voltage is the voltage when there is no current, and short circuit is the maximum current when the terminals are connected to each other. Why it is maximum? Because when the terminals are connected to each other, in that case we can say that there is zero resistance. Okay, so ideally we are considering it zero, but practically it is not zero, it is something in point. So but in this case the current is maximum, we can say. So it is the short circuit current when the terminals are connected to each other. Now the efficiency of solar cell is defined as the electric power output divided by the incident light energy power output to input. We can say efficiency is the ratio of output to input, and fill factor is calculated from the IV characteristics of solar cell. This is the IV characteristics of solar cell, and from this characteristic we can easily calculate the fill factor. So the applications are, solar cell panels are used in UPS, uninterrupted power supply, water heaters with hybrid designating backup by batteries. So you can say lots of applications of solar cells in your households also. Water heaters are there, then there are solar calculators, then solar electric generators are also there. So a lot of applications you can see in today's world, because it does not require any kind of maintenance. So that's why solar energy is very much in demand nowadays, we can say. So next lecture is bipolar junction transistor, because today we have completed all the things related with the semiconductor diodes, at least related with the FY BSc computer science syllabus. I am strictly following the syllabus of Savitribai Phule Pune University, but still all these slides are very much useful for all the electronics, basic electronic students, I can say, for 11th, 12th bifocal electronic students can also refer them, and for FY students it is must. So thank you so much. If you like this video, please like, subscribe and share. My channel is Easy Electronics. Thank you so much.